Hello, Middle 3. Today we will explain Lesson 3 in Unit 1, Physical Quantities, Scalars and Vectors. To understand the physical phenomena which represent the greatest part of physics, it's necessary to deal with physical quantities and mathematical relations. So, what's the meaning of physical quantity? Physical quantity is any quantity that has been determined and has a measuring unit in our life. For example, like mass, length, time, speed, force, energy, and temperature. Types of physical quantities: scalars and vectors. To describe a scalar physical quantity, it's enough to know its magnitude only. What's the meaning of magnitude? It's numeric value and measuring unit. So what's the meaning of a scalar physical quantity? It's a physical quantity that has magnitude only and has no direction. For example, like mass by kilogram, length by meter, speed by kilometer per hour or meter per second, time by second or minute or hour, energy by joule, temperature by Celsius or Fahrenheit. So, give reason. Length and time are scalar quantities because they have magnitude only and have no directions. To describe a vector physical quantity, it's necessary to know its magnitude, its numeric value and measuring unit, and also its direction. So what's the meaning of vector physical quantity? It's quantities that have magnitudes and directions. For example, weight by Newton, acceleration by meter per second square, force by Newton, velocity by meter per second, and displacement by meter. So, when I ask you, give reason. Acceleration and force are vector quantities because they have magnitude and direction. There are some physical quantities that seem at first sight to be similar, but they have a great difference in their concept, such as distance and displacement. To understand the difference between distance and displacement, study the following example. When a car moves from position A to position B, as shown in the previous figure, the length of the curved line gives you the distance covered by the car. The straight line that starts from point A and point B in the direction AB gives the displacement of the car. So, distance is the length of the curved line covered by the car from A to B, and displacement is the shortest length between A and B in direction AB. For example, when a car moves from a starting point A to the point B, then to the end point C, as shown in the opposite figure. Therefore, the distance covered by the car from point A to reach point C equal AB plus BC equal 40 plus 30 equal 70 meters. But the displacement from point A to point C equal 50 meter in the direction AC in the northernmost direction. Another example, when a body moves in a direct straight line from A to B covering 50 meter, then it returns back to A. The distance from A to B to A equal 50 plus 50. Equal 100 meter, but the displacement from A to B to A equals 0. Why? Because the body doesn't change its position. From the previous examples, we conclude that distance is the actual length of the path that a moving body covers from the starting point to the ending point, which is determined by magnitude only, and its unit is meter, its kind scalar quantity. The displacement is the shortest distance between the starting point and the ending point, determined by magnitude and direction, its unit meter, and its kind vector quantity. What's mean by the body moves in a direct straight line in one direction? Means the displacement of the body equal the distance covered. What's mean by the displacement from Alexandria to Cairo is 200 km in western north direction? It means the length of the shortest straight line from Alexandria to Cairo is 200 km in the western north direction. Speed and velocity. The velocity is the speed in a given direction when the body moves in a straight line in one direction. So speed is scalar, needs magnitude only, and velocity is vector, needs magnitude and direction. We can calculate average velocity from the total displacement covered by the object in 1 second, or it is the rate of a change of displacement. So average is velocity equal displacement divided by total time. But speed or average speed equal total distance divided by total time. The measuring units of velocity is meter per second or kilometer per hour. The same measuring units of speed, meter per second or kilometer per hour. For example, a person covers 30 meters from A to B in 30 seconds, then 60 meters from B to C in 20 seconds, then 30 meters from C to D in 10 seconds. Therefore, his path E to B to C to D. Starting point is A and ending point is D. So the distance covered 30 plus 60 plus 30 equal 120 meters. The total time 30 plus 20 plus 10 equals 60 seconds. The displacement 60 meters in the direction AD. And the average speed, total distance divided by total time, equal 120 divided by 60, equal 2 meters per second. So the average velocity is displacement divided by total time, equal 60 divided by 60, equal 1 meter per second in AD direction. Technological applications. Movement of the Earth around itself causes a movement of wind on its surface. The amount of consumed fuel by a plane flies between two cities differ according to the wind direction. Why? Because when the plane flies against the wind direction, it consumes more fuel than when it flies in the same wind direction.